and probably fewer health care providers make medical service better. I see this health bill not as reform, but pure government takeover. I am definitely...
We're back. Time now for the Politics Fix with Joan Walsh of Salon and syndicated columnist Tony Blankley. Tony Blankley, I know you believe in truth, justice, and the American way, and so I want you to address that woman's comment that we just heard where she said that this bill will provide fewer health care providers. Will you please tell her that there's nothing in this bill that reduces the number of health care providers in this country? Come on, Tony, tell him
now. No, because there is, of course, as you know, no bill. One of the president's problems is
of the bills that have been written, there's not a sentence about reducing the number of medical school graduates, right?
Can't we just get along here? No, look, the problem is, it's the same problem that George Bush had in 2005 on Social Security, that unless there is one, which he didn't have one specific bill with all the details, as a result, every possible negative could be raised by his opposition. The same is true for the president today, that there are five separate bills. We have no idea what the final bill is going to look like. Inferences can be drawn fairly and unfairly and are, and that's, of course, the way it is in American politics. And the president is now caught having to counterpunch against a lot of things that he may not have considered.
Joan Walsh, but Tony's right. There are five written bills, and in not one of them does it say we will have fewer health care providers, and here's what the government will do to make that happen. And for Tony and for other Republicans not to be able to acknowledge that this simply has not been written, it is no one's intent, let's argue about those three new tax brackets invented by the Ways and Means Committee. Why they can't argue about that and choose to and like to have arguments about things that aren't in the bill is what's getting us stuck here where we can't get anywhere.
I think we know why. I think, you know, there are no death panels in the bill. Chuck Grassley just blew my mind today. I don't think of him as a bomb-throwing, irresponsible, lying conservative, but he lied today, and we know it, Lawrence. There are no death panels. We're not pulling the plug on grandma. And so when people stoop to that level, yes, there are five bills, and I'm going to give Tony some credit here. I think Obama has to step up and begin to narrow the range of choices that he will accept in terms of how we pay for this and the issue of the public option. If he's not going to go for it, I think he has to, and I think he will. But if he's not, if he's going to cave on that, then say that, and we'll have a different debate. But the fact that he hasn't is because he's working with Republicans. He's talking to Chuck Grassley and trying to get a bipartisan bill. That's starting to seem crazy to me because Republicans are lying about everything he does.
Tony, let me just read to you and the audience what Chuck Grassley said today. He was asked about the death panels, as he was bound to be asked about them, and he said, "You have a right to be afraid." That's how he begins his answer. And his final line on it is, we should not have a government program that determines if you're going to pull the plug on grandma. Now, every Democrat, when asked that question, says, there is nothing like it in the bills. No one's going to do that. It isn't going to happen. Grassley, who knows everything that's in every one of these bills, he's a key Republican negotiator. He refuses to tell the truth to his Iowa voters and say, don't worry, it's not there. You have no reason to be worried about it. Instead, he says, you have a reason to be worried and we shouldn't do it. Go ahead, Tony.
As you know, implications that may not be in a specific piece of legislation come up. Let me give you an example of
that ain't one of them, Tony. Come on, that ain't one of them.
It's not.
Let me finish a sentence, please. Sure. New York Times, April 29th of this year, President Barack Obama said his grandmother's hip replacement surgery during the final weeks of her life made him wonder whether expensive procedures for the terminally ill reflect a, quote, sustainable model for health care. It goes on. Now, it's certainly not in this bill right now, but if the public knows that the President of the United States, who's going to have a big role in shaping the final bill, thinks that there's an issue about grandmothers, whether we should, and this is his words from the New York Times, that maybe we can't afford to provide it, you can understand why people are a little worried. It doesn't mean it's in the bill now, but we had the same issue on our welfare bill back in 95.
All right, we're going to skip welfare for today. Hold it right there, Tony. We'll be back with Joan Walsh and Tony Blankley for more of the Politics Fix. We're back with Joan Walsh and Tony Blankley for more of the Politics Fix. Joan Walsh, the White House completed today this perfect execution on the confirmation of Sonia Sotomayor. How can this same operation that handled that so beautifully, they were told by Republicans, do not try to get her confirmed that fast. We will get in the way. They said, never, you know, they just steamrolled right past them. They confirmed her fast. How can that same team be so bogged down on health care reform?
Well, you know, they got bogged down a little bit in the beginning about the issues of her speeches and the wise Latina remark, Lawrence. So, you know, but in the end, she turned out to be, she's one person. She had a record of some speeches. She certainly had a judicial record, but she was finite. You know, you could examine everything she stood for, and you could say, yes, she's qualified, or no, she isn't, and they decided she was qualified. I understand why this is harder. I just think, as I said before, that Obama now needs to step up and really define some of the issues that he is left undefined, because he is losing the momentum at this point.
Tony Blankley, what's your recommendation for Republican House members? Just stay quiet in August and let the Democrats trip over themselves?
No, I think they should be talking to their members carefully, getting them to the public, getting their message out. But largely, I think this is a Democratic battle with itself right now. The Republican job is to drive useful messages.
All right. Thank you, Joan Walsh and Tony Blankley. Tony Blankley, one of the most honorable Republicans I know, but still can't admit when what the truth is in this debate.